everybody. Susan here, and just coming to share a few thoughts with you this afternoon. This is around about take 7. I've never done this before, and it's taken a little bit of getting used to, so bear with me. What I was going to say to you was that one of the ways God sometimes talks to me is through the lyrics of a secular song that he might just drop into my mind out of the blue. And today I did come across a really iconic song and felt the Lord just speaking to me through it, and I thought I would just share that with you. So the song is called Ain't No Mountain High Enough. I'm sure many of you will have heard that song, and let me just read a few of the lyrics to you. Listen, ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough. If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far, don't worry. Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry, you don't have to worry. 'Cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, babe. Remember the day I set you free. I told you you could always count on me. From that day on, I made a vow. I'll be there when you want me, some way, somehow. 'Cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, babe. Well, that song, it just made me think about the mountains and the valleys that we face right now as individuals and families, as local communities, and, you know, nationally and globally, right across the world. We are facing mountains that seem insurmountable, valleys that seem that we're never going to find our way out of it. But I just feel so encouraged today that God speaking to me through the words of this song, and he's saying there is nothing that can stand in the way of me getting to you, of me being with you, of me rescuing you. And I just want to declare today, we have a faithful, all-powerful God. He is the creator, and every living thing will bow the knee to Jesus, even every living organism, every living virus. Coronavirus will bow the knee to Jesus. I just decree and declare in Jesus' name. And can I share with you from Psalm 34, the Passion Translation? It's entitled God's Goodness, and I'm just going to read a few verses starting at verse 4. Listen to my testimony. I cried to God in my distress, and he answered me. He freed me from all my fears. And I just want to thank you today, God, that we cry to you and you hear us, you answer us, and you come in, Holy Spirit, and you displace that fear that comes against us, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord, that your love casts out all fear. Verse 5 says, gaze upon him, join your life with his, and joy will come. Your faces will glisten with glory. You'll never wear that shame face again. When I had nothing, desperate and defeated, I cried out to the Lord and he heard me, bringing his miracle deliverance when I needed it most. The angel of the Lord stooped down to listen as I prayed, encircling me, empowering me, and showing me how to escape. Lord, I just want to thank you today that you hear us. Lord, you answer and you bring your miracle deliverance, Lord, when we need it. Thank you, God, that you stoop down and listen as we pray, that you encircle and empower us and show us the way of escape. Lord God, I just pray today, and we join our prayers, Lord, with people up and down the nation and around the world, and we ask for that miracle deliverance from you, God. We pray, Lord, that you would release from heaven, Lord, the science, the technology, the medical breakthroughs, Lord, the breakthroughs in research. God, we pray that you would move by the power of your Spirit, Lord, and you would bring a mighty deliverance for the peoples of the earth. We ask it in Jesus' name. And I thank you, God, that you are always good, Lord, that you have come to bring life, Lord, life in abundance, God. And we bless your name today. And Father, I just pray that you would encircle and encompass, Lord, every person that hears this message, and Lord, that you would encompass them with your peace and your love and your rest, because you are good, Lord. So thank you, Lord, for our time together today. And everybody, I'm just going to play a little bit of that great song for you, and I hope it encourages you just as it encouraged me. So thank you, Lord. Amen.